Today, I'm going to show you how to make your resume look like this using good old Microsoft Word. I know Word can be tricky to navigate sometimes, but don't worry. I've talked to our designer who made all of our templates, and this is the ultimate guide for you. First, open a blank document in Microsoft Word, and let's get it set up with the right margins. I'm just going to have a block of text here to show you the differences. Head over to the Layout tab, click the Margins button, and set them between 0.5 and 1 inch. Normally, the default is at 1 inch. This will give your resume plenty of white space for a nice, clean look. Next, choose a font that's clean and easy to read, like Times New Roman, Arial, or Calibri. Stick to an 11 or 12 point font size for most of your text. If you want to get real fancy, we'll talk more about fonts and colors later in this video. For the header, you'll list your name and contact details. Type your full name and bump up the font size, usually between 24 and 32 points. Then, center the text and make it bold so your name really stands out. Hit enter and type out your contact details. For this part, you should drop the font size down to 12 or 14 points. Add your resume summary right below this. This is a 2-3 sentence paragraph that highlights your key skills and accomplishments. If you need help writing one, we have a video just for you. I'll leave the link below. Moving on to the tricky part, setting up sections for your experience, education, and skills. The easiest way is to hit enter to create space in between sections. Hit enter and then type out the heading, like professional experience, in around 14 to 16 point bold font. You can also use horizontal lines as dividers, which will look like this in the end. Go to the Home tab and click Borders. Choose Horizontal Line, and it will insert a solid line across the page. Double-click on the line, and it'll pull up all the settings you can play around, like changing the width or color. Once you are happy with the look, follow the same steps to add different sections. You've probably noticed a lot of templates with columns. Here are a few easy ways to create them based on what you need. One way is to use tables. Go to Insert, and then to Table. Let's go with three columns here. Drag the bottom line to expand it, or go to Layout to enter the numbers for height and width. And just like the horizontal lines, you can do all sorts of things with the settings under Table Design. Now, I'm going to squeeze the middle column like this to give it some space in between. I'll tell you why in a sec. Let me paste in some sample text here first. Still under Table Design, highlight the whole thing and click No Border. And now you have nice clean sections of text. You can highlight the page to find your invisible table. Spend some time tweaking the table to find the best layout that highlights your experience. Here's another way to create columns. I'm going to use a block of text to show you this one. Let's make some space here. Go to Layout and Columns, then pick the one you like. If you need more than three, go to More Columns and adjust the number here. But honestly, you probably won't need more than two for your resume. In the same setting box, check Line Between and hit OK. And this is how it looks like. Even if you have a lot to say, make sure there's proper spacing for readability. Under Layout, Spacing, you can adjust the numbers based on your content. This gives you more control than just hitting enter. Deciding where to put your professional experience, skills, education, and other info is super important. It all depends on your background and the job requirements. If you need more tips on how to strategically place your sections, we've got a video that covers it all. I'll drop the link below. If you just want to send your resume out now, simply fast forward to our final tip. But for those who want to get a bit more creative and fancy, here are some tips for choosing fonts and colors. A common practice is pairing a serif font for headings, for example, Times New Roman, with a sans serif font for body text, for example, Arial. By the way, this is a serif font, and this is a sans serif font. You can also bold the title and bump up the size for clarity. Regular body text should remain simple for readability. You don't want the hiring manager to trash your resume just because they can't understand it. When picking colors for your resume, think about the job and industry you're aiming for. For more serious fields, like finance or law, stick with classic neutrals like navy blue, dark gray, or maroon in order to keep it professional. But if you're in a creative field like marketing or design, feel free to add a splash of color. Teal, soft purple, or gentle coral can really make your resume pop. Use accent colors to highlight key sections, but keep it subtle so it doesn't overpower the rest. Under Home, you can simply change your text color. No matter the fonts or colors you end up using, make sure they are the same for the entire resume in order to look professional and consistent. You can also apply them to your cover letter to create a cohesive look. Just don't go overboard with too many fonts and formatting styles. Simple and crisp is the best. Once everything is done, do a final check on everything. Make sure the section titles stand out and the body is easy to read. Before you send your new resume out to employers, be sure to proofread carefully, have friends or family take a look, and adjust things as needed. When you're happy with how your resume looks, save it as a PDF to make sure your formatting stays consistent. Best of luck from the Resume Genius team, and we'll see you in the next video.